All right, welcome. Today, we are stepping right into the middle of an economic tug of war. We're going to see what happens when two of the most fundamental forces in the market, supply and demand, start pulling in completely opposite directions at the very same time. It's a classic puzzle, and it unpacks something really cool about how our world works. So here's the big question for you. Imagine demand for a product just tanks, but at the exact same moment, some new innovation makes it way cheaper and easier to produce than ever before. So which force wins? Do prices just crash? And what happens to the actual amount of stuff people are buying and selling?
Now to tackle this, we're not just going to wing it. We're going to use a brilliantly simple framework laid out by economist Michael Revif in his lectures on this very topic. His method is perfect for cutting right through the noise and finding a clear path to the answer.
And the product at the center of our puzzle today? Well, it's something you probably have in your kitchen right now. White flour. It's the perfect everyday example to see these huge economic forces play out. So let's paint the picture. We're looking at the market for white flour. Now, economists call this a normal good. We'll talk about what that means in a sec. And two things are happening at once. First, people's incomes are going down. And second, a brand new technology is making flour production way more efficient. Okay, so how do you even begin to untangle this? Well, the key, and this is straight from Revif's playbook, is you have to resist the urge to look at everything at once. You've got to break it down. We're going to analyze each of these events totally on their own, and then we'll bring them back together. So let's start with event number one. Let's imagine, just for a moment, that awesome new technology. It doesn't exist yet. The only thing we care about right now is what happens when people simply have less money to spend. And this is where that fancy-sounding term, normal good, becomes super important. But really, it's a simple idea. For most things we buy, like groceries or new clothes, when our income drops, we buy less of them. That's a normal good.
So the logic here is pretty straightforward, right? Less money in people's pockets means they're not buying as much flour, no matter the price. On a graph, that means the whole demand curve shifts inward, to the left. And the result of that shift, all by itself, is that both the price of flour and the total amount sold are going to fall.
All right, we've got part one down. Let's hit the reset button. Now we're going to totally forget about incomes for a second and just focus on that cool new production technology.
Better tech means producers can make way more flour for less money. This is a classic supply boost. For economists, this shifts the supply curve outwards, to the right. Now pay attention to the result here. This force also pushes the price down. But, and this is the whole point, it pushes the quantity sold up.
And boom, there it is, the heart of our puzzle. We've got two different things happening. The first one is slamming the brakes on quantity. The second one is hitting the gas. They are in a direct head-to-head conflict. So what gives when they collide?
This is where we pull out the main tool from the economist's toolkit. We've taken the problem apart, piece by piece. Now it's time to put it all back together and see the complete picture. And you might think we need some super complicated math here, but nope. The best way to see what's happening is with a surprisingly simple table. It's a fantastic way to organize all this conflicting info and get a clear answer. Okay, let's walk through this together. Look at that first row, falling demand. We saw it pushes price down and quantity down. Got it? Now the second row, that rising supply from the new tech, it also pushes price down, but it pushes quantity up. So when we add it all up for the total effect, check out the price column, down and down. It's a no-brainer, right? The price is definitely going to fall. But now, look at the quantity column. We've got a down arrow fighting an up arrow. So let's just spell this out so it's crystal clear. When it comes to price, both forces are singing the same tune. They're both pushing it lower, so there's no mystery. But for quantity, the forces are in that tug of war we talked about. One pulls it down, the other pulls it up. The final result is totally ambiguous. So now we can finally put it all together. We can give the final, conclusive answer to our economic puzzle. The first part of our answer is certain. When demand falls and supply rises at the same time, we can say with 100% confidence that the market price of that product is going down. No doubt about it. But, and this is the big reveal here, we have absolutely no idea for sure what will happen to the total amount of flour sold. Was the drop in demand just a little nudge, or was it a giant shove? Was the new technology a small improvement, or was it a total game changer? Without knowing the size of each shift, the only correct answer has to be, we don't know. And this quote just captures the wisdom here perfectly. Sometimes the smartest, most accurate answer you can give in economics isn't some precise number. It's an honest admission of uncertainty. Knowing what you can't know is just as powerful as knowing what you can. Which kind of leaves us with one last thing to think about. In a world that is obsessed with big data and getting a concrete answer for everything, we just discovered that sometimes the most powerful insight is knowing the limits of your knowledge, recognizing where the real uncertainty is. Isn't that a kind of superpower?